Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about how to eliminate nightmares of debugging concurrency problems using JCStress. Here's my intro. My name is Vipin Sharma. I'm senior software developer having 12 plus years of experience with Java. I help professional Java developers to learn language features so they can work on best Java projects. I write about Java language features on my blog jfeatures.com. Now let's start our discussion on JCStress. Incorrect concurrent programs can run for years, tricking us to believe it is stable code, and it fails when we least expect. We all know writing concurrent program is hard, testing concurrent program is harder, and in case of a concurrency bug, debugging concurrent program is nightmare. So it is very important to test our concurrent programs. Why run this risk? When OpenJDK provides an amazing tool to test correctness of your concurrent programs, meet JCStress, a concurrency stress test tool developed and used by JVM developers to test correctness of JVM itself. Let's test our concurrent programs using JCStress. We'll see how to use JCStress now. Let's try to understand our first test. This is taken from JCStress GitHub repo. First, we'll try to understand basic JCStress annotations used in this. Class API sample underscore 01 underscore simple is annotated with JCStress test. That makes it a JCStress test. Same class has test outcomes using outcome annotation. It is also annotated with state. It holds state of test in field V. We are using II underscore result here to store test results. If we look at implementation of II result, it is annotated with result and it stores result of test in two int type fields R1 and R2. Now at the end, our most important annotation is actor. It marks methods that holds action done by threads. Each method is called only by one particular thread. Each method is called exactly once per state instance, which in our case is instance of API sample underscore 01 underscore simple. Now let's look at how this test works. Methods actor 1 and actor 2 are called by particular threads. Let's say T1 and T2. Both T1 and T2 increments field V and stores result in instance of II underscore result, which is shared by both the threads. And at the end of test, we check outcome and print the results. Now let's look at three outcomes. Outcomes 1, 2 and 2, 1 are acceptable here because invocation order of thread is not specified. Anyone can execute first. But outcome 1, 1 is interesting because both threads have incremented and only one update we see in the result. And we know this is expected as per Java memory model. We can write another test and use atomic integer in place of int to fix this. Let's do that. This is another example from JCStress repo. We are introducing two new concepts here. First, nested test. We are showing only one test here, but we can club together related tests in the same class. For example, create public static class plain increment and write actor methods for that as well in the same class. And second concept is arbiter. Arbiter visits the state instance after all the actors have already visited that instance. All memory effects from actors are visible in arbiter. This makes arbiter very useful for reading the final state into results. Now, if you look at outcomes, one is forbidden. Your test will fail when you have result one because we don't expect to miss any update. Now let's talk about how can you set up JCStress test for your project. If you want to use JCStress as separate dependency in your project, then you are recommended to create a submodule with JCStress test, which would use JCStress libraries and build steps. The easiest way to bootstrap the project with JCStress is to use Maven archetype, what we are showing in this slide. And after creating project, This is the way you build your project and run any test. Here, first we run command mvn clean verify, then running jcstress.char executes all available tests in that. We can also specify test name using argument minus t. For example, in this slide, we have passed test name concurrency test, which is default test created using Maven archetype. At the end of test, report is created in result directory. Now it's demo time. Let's look at demo. This is JCStress GitHub repo in IntelliJ IDEA I have right now. This parent module has couple of submodules. One is for benchmarks, other is for core classes, then few other modules we have, and two submodules I want to talk about are JCStress samples and JC and test customs. First, let's look at JCStress samples. We'll open sources, Java. If you look at this, this is the same example we saw a few minutes back. Okay. And then 1 to 6, if you look at these examples, explain how JCStress API works. Yeah, the second one explains arbiters, then a few other things. And then some interesting examples, like related, first one is related to concurrency sample. Let's open this. So this one you see on my screen is atomic increment. This we saw a few minutes back. This is the same test case we have taken from this same repo. Then few other tests related to Java memory model, which are interesting tests, like finals, how finals are initialized. You can look at this. It has couple of nested tests, like the plain initialization. Then we have final initialization. So two tests it has. Okay. Now this is one submodule, interesting submodule you should check out. Then we have one more submodule, test custom. Test custom. Let's go to some sources. Let's see what are different tests already we have. So you look at this, there are categories: atomicity, atomics, collections, executors, instances, futures. So couple of interesting categories we have. You can look at singleton. Let's open the singleton. We have double check locking related test, we have singleton related different tests we have here. We can look at volatile. There are couple of tests related to volatile. We have a couple of tests related to thread locals, and all these are interesting tests you should see. It will help you to understand how this API works in case you get stuck somewhere someday or writing a test, you need an example, you can go through these tests. Okay. Now let's try to run one test here. Let's try to execute our first test. We'll say Java minus char. I know my test is present in JCStress samples. No jar is available in target. Now I can run this, and this is going to execute all the tests available. But I want to test only one particular test just to be quick and show the results. Let's execute this. It should be fast. It is a basic test. It has already completed half of the iterations. You can see it is printing results as well after each test. And consolidated result is available in the HTML. It says look at result. index.html for complete run results. Let's look at what is there in index.html and how do we interpret results. I'm not showing entire result HTML here, just test outcome part. Let's try to see how do we read this and what all type of tests are executed by JCStress. Here we can see four types of tests are executed by JCStress. Let's talk about all of these four. Test case one. The important part here is different JVM options are used. So test one is using JVM option minus tiered compilation. It helps to disable C1 compiler. Then test case two is using two additional options, stress LCM plus stress GCM. Let's try to understand what is stress LCM and stress GCM. LCM stands for local code motion. GCM stands for global code motion. As performance optimization, compiler may reorder independent instructions without changing semantics of code. Compiler tries to find the most optimal order of instructions. When we use stress LCM and stress GCM, the instruction scheduling works in a different way. It chooses a random instruction order, which is allowed in the Java memory model. It helps simulating different scenarios for our concurrency test. Let's look at test case 3 now. Test case 3 is using JVM option tiered stop at level equals to 1. It is used to disable C2 compiler. Now I'll go to test case 4. Test case 4 is using minus XINT. This option runs application in interpreted mode. Here, compilation to native code is disabled and all the bytecode is executed by interpreter. Let's look at some more useful APIs JCStress provides. It has signal, shared metadata, adding test description references. Let's look at all of these in a demo. We already talked about 01_simple and 02_arbiters. Now it's time to talk about termination and other samples. We talk about JCStress API. 03 termination is going to introduce a new API signal. Let's look at how signal works. This is documentation for signal. It says it is useful for delivering a termination signal to actor. It will run after actor execution started executing. Let's go to our class. Let's see how it works. Here, one important part here is this test is annotated with JCStress test and it has mode termination. Okay. Now we have actor 1 and signal, two methods over here. One thread is going to execute actor 1, another thread is going to execute signal. When actor 1 is being executed by a thread, it checks V. V is equal to, if V is equal to 0, it goes inside, it does nothing. But if nobody is changing V, it will go in infinite loop and test will hang up. Another thread is going to execute signal and it is going to set V is equals to 1. When V becomes 1, ideally actor 1 should receive and we come out of this. It gets terminated successfully. But there's no guarantee the value set by another thread which was executing signal is going to reach to this thread which is executing actor 1 because of Java memory model. So that's the reason if you look at outcome, it has terminated and stale. And when we execute this result, we get some tests in stale case as well. So this test got this this thread does not receive a signal. Let's talk about another feature, nesting. We already saw this little bit. Let's look at the example. In nesting, we are trying to club related test cases together in a class. Here we have plain test one class and volatile test one class. Both of them have different annotations, different metadata they are using. Okay. Now let's look at another API feature where this metadata can be put together in a class and it can be shared. This is one such example. Here we have two tests, plain test and volatile test. We have metadata at class level and metadata both of the tests also have. But if you look at these tests, both of the tests are using some metadata from the class. It says API simple _05 _share metadata dot class. So use my metadata from this class. It is also possible we can create some class with only metadata and use that class at other places. Let's look at another API which provides description. So it helps writing description to our test report. We can add test description. We can also add references. Let's look at the result after running this test. This is a snippet from test report having description and reference for our test API sample _06 _descriptions. If you look at this, this is our description sample hello world test, and this is our reference. Okay. So similarly, we can add our references, we can add our descriptions. JCStress has a couple of helpful command line options. Some of those are modes, test names, verbose result, number of CPUs used. Let's look at some of these. You can use -h command to get list of options available in JCStress. Let's run this command and see this. If you look at some of the options, -c is an option. We can specify number of CPUs to use. All the options has nice description as well along with that. Like -h, this is the option we saw we used to print this help. Then we can use -iterations, iteration per test. We can use -jvm args to specify JVM arguments. Then we have -l, which gives list of available tests matching the requested settings. We have -m. This is an important, we should talk about this. Mode is an important annotation. There are a couple of values. It has sanity, quick, default, tough, and stress. This is the basic one. And then as we go on the right side, our test becomes more rigorous. And definitely we want to use stress in our concurrency test at least first time, because we want to make sure we try to run many iterations possible and all possible reorderings we want to see. Then we have memory footprint related argument. Then we have strides related argument. We have option to specify directory with -r. We can say we can give target destination to put our report into, and we have already seen minus D, we have already seen minus V. So these are a few important helpful options, command line options we have seen. The result classes is one important part in JCStress. We looked at ii underscore result so far. Ii underscore result had two integer variables. That's the reason it starts with ii. If we had three integer variables, the name is going to be iii underscore results. These are pre-canned classes, some pre-canned classes available in JCStress. And the naming convention is given over here. I stands for integer, Z stands for boolean, F stands for float, J stands for long, S for short, B for byte, C for char, D for double, L for object. Let's look at some of these classes in code. This is one class. Let's go to this class. If you see, this is one of the class, and there are a lot of such class available in the same package. This is part of JCStress code, and these are generated classes. It has B underscore result, it has BB underscore result. Let's look at one class, BB underscore result. So B, we know B for byte. So it has two byte variables, R1 and R2. Let's look at our class IA underscore result. It has two integer variables, R1 and R2. Similarly, there are other examples. We have BBC, that means two bytes and one character. And a lot of such combinations are available. We have BCD, where B for byte, C for character, and D for double. There are other examples. We have some cases, a lot of characters available here. So this is about result class. There's one more important class I want to show you. That is also part of JCStress code. Let me close all of these first. Class is options. This class helps us to understand a lot of things happens in the JCStress test. What I'm trying to show you here is mode. Say this. Here, on basis of mode, it decides couple of things. If it is sanity, then only one iteration, one for, batch size 500, stride size is this, and then if it is quick, then it increases time. It increases iterations. If it is default, then it increases time to 5 times. Then when it is tough, it increases number of iterations. When it is stress, it increases number of iterations to 50. So this way we can try to understand more about how JCStress works. These are helpful links which help you to understand JCStress better, also help you to understand how can you utilize this in your project. Let's go through GitHub link first. JCStress falls in OpenJDK organization. If you look at this readme file, it talks about samples. We already saw this. We have three type of samples: API sample, JMM sample, concurrency sample. And this is the way we can run the command and we can run our test. What I would like to highlight here is extending the test part. If you find an interesting test, please consider contributing it back. JCStress is available on GitHub. You can raise in PR now. One other important thing I would like to highlight is this part has recommendation. How can you use JCStress for your project? The first one says recommendation is create some module with JCStress test. And for quick way, the easy way is to bootstrap project with JCStress is to use the archetype, which we did in our demo. Another important link I would like to highlight here is Eclipse collection. This is one of the sample project I have chosen. Let me show you this. This is Eclipse collection project. And it has a couple of submodules. JCStress tests is one of the submodule, which is exactly same as what was recommended on JCStress GitHub repo. With this, we are at the end of our session. And please feel free to ask any questions you have now.